Item number, SCP-404. Object class, safe. Special containment procedures. SCP-404 is to be kept in Section Alpha-1 of the document's repository. Any movement of SCP-404 beyond Section Alpha-1 will result in termination. Description. SCP-404 is a pair of large manila envelopes, one of which has a series of pages attached to the front. Each page is stamped with a name, date, time, and number table, and contains multiple entries with known and unknown names. The ink has been dated to 1833, plus or minus 10 years, and the folder dated to 1834, plus or minus 10 years. Many signatures are noted on the grid, notably those of former document repository administrators expunged. All signatures also are followed by a numerical reference number. Currently, there are over 1,000 signatures on these pages, with additional pages appearing on their own when the previous ones become full. A count of these pages has proven impossible, as has the contents of the envelope as mentioned later. Contained inside SCP-404 are a series of large 8x10 photographs. Attempts to count the exact numbers of photographs have thus far failed. When a person attempts to count the total photographs, they will invariably get a number wrong at least twice, and have to start over. If more than one person attempts to count them, they will begin to debate what number they were at last, and start over. If a mechanized system is used to count the photographs, it will either glitch, fail, freeze, or skip, causing a recount to be required. Any person may pick up and access the first envelope, known as SCP-404-A. They may withdraw a single photograph at a time from the envelope. This photo will always be blank when drawn out, and will remain so until 5 seconds have passed. Should the photo remain in contact with the person who drew it longer than 5 seconds, it will then begin to fade into an image, in the same way a Polaroid develops. This image will be a crystal clear image from an event in the holder's past, which, thus far, has always been immediately recognized by the holder. Once this photograph has been developed, it will no longer fit into SCP-404-A, no matter what effort is applied to it. This image will fit perfectly into the second envelope, SCP-404-B. An undeveloped photo will not fit into SCP-404-B. After a developed photo is placed inside of SCP-404-B, the pages attached to the front of the envelope will update themselves, with the name, date, time, and an incrementing number. If a person picks up SCP-404-B, they immediately know which pages contain lines with their name, although they may not know the numbers. When they have viewed the numbers, or if they already know the number, they are able to draw that photo out of SCP-404-B, with only a few seconds of searching. The most disconcerting feature of SCP-404-B is that once the subject has left the presence of the envelopes for longer than an hour, they forget interacting with either envelope, as well as the memory imprinted on the photo. This effect lasts until the subjects re-enter the presence of SCP-404-A or B, at which time they regain their memory of having used the envelopes, but will not remember the event on the photograph until it is viewed again. Researchers who oversee the testing of SCP-404-A or B, but who do not interact with the contents of the envelope, are capable of remembering both the test and the image to the best their natural memory allows. Document number 4041. Subject is Class D personnel who has been instructed to draw 5 photos from SCP-404-A. First photo drawn contains an image of a young girl on a tire swing, being pushed from behind. Subject confirms that the girl is their younger sister at age 6. Second photo contains image of the same girl, now older, nude, in a bedroom setting, laying on a bed and smiling, wagging finger at the viewer. Subject confirms once again that this is their sister, and is noted becoming distressed. Third photo drawn contains image of same girl, older again, in the garb of high school graduation with her arm around a male of similar age. Subject confirms again this is his sister and the boy is her boyfriend. Subject seems agitated, and reluctant to continue, until assured he must only draw two more photos. Fourth photo drawn contains image of a car that has gone half off of a road. The windows on all sides are smashed, and the driver door is open. In the driver's seat is the same boy from the previous photo, with no discernible age difference. There is considerable bodily damage on the boy, as well as a slit throat. Subject confirms this is the same boy. Fifth photo drawn shows a funeral setting. The girl from the previous photos is the center of focus. She is wearing a black funeral dress and has a hateful expression. Subject confirms that this is his sister again. All photos drawn will no longer fit into SCP-404-A, so are filed inside of SCP-404-B. Subject's name, current date, and numbers now appear on the topmost sheet of SCP-404-B. After the test had completed, the subject was allowed to leave the testing area, and then questioned about the photos. After a time lapse of approximately 1 hour, subject became unable to answer any further questions about the photos, and denied having ever been part of a test for this day. The subject is unable to account for the time spent in the testing chamber, and also denies knowledge of ever attending a funeral with his sister for any individual. Up until the time threshold had passed, subject had been willing to answer any and all questions regarding the incident in the photos. Loss of memory attributed to interaction with SCP-404-A and B. Document 404-2. Subject is Dr. who has recently been through an overly dramatic breakup of a relationship. She has volunteered for this test, and has been informed of the anticipated results. First photo drawn from SCP-404-A develops into the image of a young man in overalls, leaning against a car, and covered in oil stains. Subject confirms this is her ex-boyfriend, and that he was mechanically inclined. Second photo drawn from SCP-404-A shows the same man in a very angry state, postured as if he is striking the viewer. Subject confirms again that this is her ex-boyfriend, and that this event is part of what led to their separation. Third photo drawn from SCP-404-A shows the same man in an amusement park setting, seated on a roller coaster beside the viewer. Subject confirms this was their first date. Fourth photo drawn from SCP-404-A is completely blank. Twice the normal time allowed for a photo to develop passes, and photo remains blank. This photo also is returned to SCP-404-A with no effort, while all other photos must be inserted into SCP-404-B, which now shows the subject's name with three new timestamps and numbers listed on its pages. After the fourth photo was drawn, subject was released and approached 3 hours later, where she was asked as to the status of her relationship with the boyfriend. Subject denies knowing any such person, or ever having participated in any tests today. Subject is also unable to account for lost time, but shows no concern over the disparity. Document number 4043. Subject for this test is Dr. Dr. was chosen at random, with no end result expected. First photo drawn is a first-person perspective of a water paint portrait being drawn. The artist's hands are visible in the photo, and Dr. confirms this is her at age 4. Second photo drawn is of an elderly man smiling. Photo perspective suggests the viewer is raised up in the air looking down at the man. Dr. confirms this is her grandfather, who passed away approximately 1.5 years later. Third photo is drawn after a brief reprise to allow Dr. to collect herself. This photo shows a funeral service, and the perspective again suggests the viewer is a short individual. Dr. confirms this is her grandfather's funeral service. This photo also shows the elderly man again at the headstone, which is the viewer's point of focus in this photo. The elderly man is marginally out of focus compared to his surroundings, which are crisp and clear. In addition, he is semi-transparent, to a degree of approximately 15%, suggesting that his presence is either a true spectral manifestation, or exists only in the mind of the viewer. Dr. requested a copy of this third photo, and a digital copy was created for her without incident. The original has been filed into SCP-404-B, and the copy is framed in Dr.'s office. Document number 4044. Subjects for this test are Dr. and Dr., whom have been working together for the past 2 years. These two doctors were chosen at random from established pairs of staff who had been working on projects together for over 1 year. Dr. draws the first photo from SCP-404-A. This photo, when developed, shows an older woman in her mid-30s on a bed, nude. The woman is posed in a data-expunged position from the viewer's perspective. Dr. identifies the woman as his wife. Dr. attempts to protest this until a photo is produced from Dr.'s wallet, which confirms the identity of the woman in the photo. The guard on staff intervene in the escalation of tempers and inform both doctors to continue with the test. Personal matters will be resolved afterwards. Dr. draws the second photo from SCP-404-A. It is of note that Dr.'s expression was malicious towards Dr. after the previous photo. The photo drawn by Dr. develops into a girl of young age who appears to be in a data-expunged pose from the viewer's perspective. This girl is confirmed as Dr.'s daughter, who is data-expunged, years old. Tension in the room escalates after this photo once more, and the guards on duty step in again. Due to the nature of the photos being drawn, only two more, one from each doctor, are requested. Dr. draws the third photo from SCP-404-A. This photo contains an image of the same girl from the second drawing, nude again, in a new pose. Dr. reluctantly confirms this is in fact his own daughter. Both doctors are calmed down by this event. However, both appear to be extremely uncomfortable and express repeated desires for this test to end. Dr. draws the final photo for this test, which after developing, appears to be Dr. wearing an evening dress. The test is immediately ended by the administering personnel, and both doctors placed on notice until the results of this test can be confirmed. A lapse of a full day's time was allowed to pass before either doctor was confronted about the previous day's test results. Neither doctor claims to have any memory of participating in any test, nor any inappropriate behavior with either each other, or any of the subjects from the photos. All photos were filed in SCP-404-B, and both doctors have been restricted access from SCP-404 from here forward. Continued observation of the doctors from this test show a 6% increase in productivity. This may or may not be related to the loss of the memories exposed in this test. Document number 4045. Subject for this test is a deceased Class D personnel who expired while engaged in testing of SCP. The body of the subject was manipulated by two members of staff in conjunction with medical implements to draw a series of photos from SCP-404-A. First photo drawn develops into a view of SCP at rest. It is assumed this is what the subject saw as the testing of SCP was commencing. Second photo drawn develops into an extreme close-up view of SCP. The nature of this photo suggests that this was the moment at which the subject expired. The right side of the photo is blacked out, as is expected from a scene viewed by a person with a single eye. Third photo drawn develops into data expunged. Test aborted immediately. After viewing of the photo sends the staff manipulating the subject's body into a state of rage. Guards enter the room to control the situation. One guard enters the same state as the research staff and turns on another guard, who is restraining the original test members. Additional armed staff enter area, and developed photo is covered by a jacket to prevent further viewing by any other staff. After the events of this test, any further exposure of the deceased with SCP-404 has been expressly forbidden. All staff who were involved in the test were restrained in solitary confinement, and after 48 hours, were given a psychological evaluation and released. Those who requested amnestics were allowed to utilize them. All photos made during this test were not filed into SCP-404-B, but were instead sequestered into the care of Dr. and are not to be accessed by any staff without maximum clearance. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-403. escalating lighter, right now, or for the complete course, watch this playlist.